Realizations will continue to remain strong. That's the word coming in from the management. The stock, of course, at 3.5% higher for the day. But let's also move on to another set of earnings, where the March quarter has been a mixed bag. And I'm talking about Hester Biosciences. They've seen a 20% jump in its bottom line, but the margins have shrunk to about 30% now this time. What were the key factors at play? Let's ask the management. Joining us on the phone line is MD and CEO Rajiv Gandhi. Good morning, sir. Thank you for joining us here on Bloomberg Quint. We just got your numbers. Given that you have more or less managed to meet your internal sales target of about 140 crores or so for FY18, what kind of growth could this lower base of FY18 translate into for next year?
We are looking at a sizable growth in this financial year. One is that our capacity for poultry vaccines has been just increased. It is already commissioned over here. Two is that we are expecting a good tender business in India for the PPR vaccines, which last year we would have got the business, but because of the year ending and the grants coming from the government, probably we will get them in this 1 month's time. Looking ahead, we definitely see at least a 15 to 20% growth in this financial year as compared to what we did in FY18.
Some concerns coming with respect to your revenues in the annual animal business. Is this a one-off? If it is a one-off, can you take us through the reasons why we've seen a fall there, and otherwise the other challenges with respect to the segment, sir?
On the large animal side, as I just mentioned, the PPR tender business, the business that we were expecting to get up to the tune of around 5 to 6 crores, we should be getting it in this quarter itself. Now, sometimes it happens. Now, when 31st March is a cutoff and something spills on to the next 1 or 2 months, yes, it does impact immediately on the balance sheet. If you really go to see a detailed more breakup between the tender and the health products, the health products has grown up by 69%, but it is a tender business which was expected has pulled us down.
So are you noticing any sort of a pickup in the exports overall? How is Africa business looking right now?
Yes, the export business, we have already got in a few registrations and we have been creating an infrastructure in a few countries in Africa. We have registered products, we have registered companies. In fact, in this quarter itself, beginning, we have already made export shipments to Africa. We see a sizable growth, at least a minimum more than 100% growth in this financial year as far as the exports are concerned. We do agree that last year we have gone short as far as exports is concerned, but we would more than recover in this beginning from the first quarter itself.
And so if you could just tell us about the new vaccines that you have in the pipeline.
The new vaccines that we have been now regularly in terms of registrations. We have a few registrations already done in a few countries. And as far as within India, new vaccines are concerned, there are two large animal vaccines which are in the pipeline and one poultry vaccine, besides a few diagnostic kits.
Right, so just a question on your capacity as well. Where does this stand right now? How are you placed with respect to utilization levels and whether or not you do require more expansion going ahead?
In terms of our plant in India, we were running short of capacity for the poultry vaccines, which we have commissioned the new expansion. It's already in production, and so that should increase our capacity for inactivated vaccines by around 35 to 40%. On the large animal vaccines, we have adequate capacity over here. We need not put any capital expenditure and we can increase the business by more than 100 to 150% with the current capacity that we have for large animals. In Nepal, we are expecting tender business from PPR, and there is a lot of capacity built up over there. There is no expansion needed. It's just the business that we are looking for in terms of PPR. If you have seen our press release, we are expanding into Africa and setting up a project in Tanzania to manufacture African-specific disease against African-specific animal diseases. So that is the next line of action that we intend to take further.
Right. And sir, I also believe you're looking to raise about $10 million from the Gates Foundation. Where would these funds be deployed?
The funds would be fully deployed in Hester Biosciences Africa, a wholly owned subsidiary of Hester Biosciences India, towards setting up this project.